Okay, this starts video number 11, which is over the musculoskeletal system. And kind of in a way of introduction, a few terms to go over. Antiarthritic, okay? An antiarthritic is basically a drug that suppresses inflammation in degenerative joint disease. And antihyperemic, of course, is a drug that reduces formation of uric acid, gout, in other words. Because the uric acid crystals seem to just crowd or accumulate in the big toe a lot of times and causes a lot of people to have a lot of pain in the big toe because of that. And antispasmodic, of course, is a drug that controls muscle spasms. Arthritis in general is simply the name for several disorders of the joints. Each of them having a different cause or treatment. Majorly, we see gouty arthritis a lot, which most of the time is in the big toe, sometimes can be in the thumb. And that's caused by this accumulation of uric acid, okay? The other arthritis, of course, is osteoarthritis. This is the one that most of us know about the most, the wear and tear on the joints. And it's usually the weight-bearing joints that manifest this a lot, hips, knees, ankles, okay, the weight-bearing joints. And then, of course, there's rheumatoid arthritis, RA, which you may know is crippling arthritis, where actually this is where you'll see people with their fingers and their hands that are really not in alignment, very swollen, and alignment is actually sometimes even changed to a certain extent. In the musculoskeletal system, we also have the word atrophy, which of course atrophy simply means a wasting away of body tissue. And you will see this with the elderly, as they age. And when it comes to the musculoskeletal system, it kind of is a use it or lose it kind of a proposition. If it's not used, there's going to be loss that happens. Demineralization could happen in the skeletal system in the bones, and muscle atrophy could happen in the muscular part of it, and muscles actually get smaller. Bursa is simply the small fluid-filled sacs that cushion places where bones and muscles rub together. So bursitis, and here again, the key is the bursa cushions. So if a person loses any type of cushioning, that rubbing together is going to simply create pain. Contracture, you know what that is, a permanent shortening of a muscle caused by muscle atrophy. And this is where, because see, everywhere you have a joint, you have muscles that attach above and below that joint, and that's of course what helps you move the joint. Well, as muscles shorten, this is what causes a contraction. So if it's in the wrist and the muscles start to get shorter, the wrist will go down. If the contraction's in the fingers and the fingers get contracted, the fingers go down like that. So that is how, as a muscle shortens, how it causes that contracture to happen. Ligaments, are the connective tissue fibers that attach one bone to another. This is what gets hurt, strained a lot of times, and causes a lot of pain. Myalgia is just simply our word for muscle pain. Osteomyelitis is an infection inside the bone. A lot of infections are really hard to clear up. Osteomyelitis is one of those. When bone infection happens, you can very well see a person on an antibiotic for a very, very long time. Skeletal muscles are the muscles that are responsible for our movement. The synovial capsule is an enclosed space between the bone and the joint, again, helping with lubrication. Tendons, of course, are connective tissue fibers that form a cord and connect muscles basically to bones, okay? So in general, that's some of the terms that are involved in the muscle skeletal system. Now, like I said, there are different types of arthritis. RA, rheumatoid arthritis, is, like I said, what we call the crippling arthritis. So with a resident with RA, you would expect that you will be giving a lot of analgesics, a lot of pain medicines. There is one thing about arthritis, and in a way, in pain in general, but especially with arthritis. When there's a full moon, of course, we know there's an increased gravitational pull on the Earth. That's when we have high tides. And when there's a weather change with the barometric pressure, both of these things, what they can do is cause soft tissue swelling. Now, and a lot of times, this is the result of pain. It results in pain. If I hit a nerve right here, just right, and hold pressure on my arm long enough, pretty soon my hand is going to start to hurt, called a pressure point, okay? And a lot of your meds for arthritis are anti-inflammatories. Now, if I'm pulling my hand down here, my finger on my arm, and pretty soon my fingers are going to start to hurt, they're going to start to tingle first and then hurt and burn. Well, the logical thing to do is what? Take off my fingers. Well, that's in pain for arthritis especially. What happens is the soft tissue pushes on a nerve, just like I was doing here with my finger and my arm. And that soft tissue, because it swells or enlarges, it pushes on a nerve. So the logical thing to do is take off the finger or reduce the inflammation, the anti-inflammatory effect. And that's what I was kind of starting to allude to with either the weather change coming in rapid that causes quick barometric pressure changes or a full moon. Both of those will cause soft tissue to swell. And that soft tissue, just like me pushing on my hand here, that soft tissue will press on nerves. And especially your folks with arthritis, you can expect them to have more pain during those times. Now, especially with a full moon or weather changes, it's just not the folks with arthritis. You will notice your folks that have headaches have more headaches during full moons or a weather change, a rapid storm coming in. People with heart problems, people with lung problems, you know, you'll talk about them, you'll hear them say how the air is heavy today. Well, what it is the pressure on the atmosphere compared to the pressure inside the chest has deviated so much, and it's making their heart have to work harder to beat, or it's giving them trouble with their lungs, and they're having trouble that way. So with these outside elements, you will always find these affecting the body. So what we can do is be a little bit proactive here, be a little bit ahead of the game, and know that when it comes time for a full moon, when it circles around, or when the weather is changing, jump the gun here a little bit and maybe give them something for pain. And especially because you're working long-term care and you know your residents very well, okay? And if you see this pattern developing with them, with your folks with arthritis or any type of pain, but especially with your folks with arthritis, knees, hips, whatever, and you start seeing that, and yeah, I noticed an increased pain with weather changes coming in fast, front, or a full moon. Okay, I've noticed that for the past couple months. Okay, let's be a little bit proactive maybe. Give them something for pain before that event happens. And maybe if we jump the gun a little bit, you know, per se, we jump the event a little bit, get ahead of it a little bit, the benefit for our resident could be a higher level of pain control. So, okay, so we've got the three types of arthritis here, three we're going to talk about. The rheumatoid arthritis is the crippling arthritis. The osteoarthritis is what we normally call degenerative joint disease. And like I said, this is our wear and tear joints, knees especially, that bear a lot of weight. And then, of course, our gout or gouty arthritis is the uric acid buildup, usually in the big toe, but I'm hearing more and more people talk about the thumb. Now, the meds we use, of course, are anti-inflammatories, okay? Aspirin, for instance, ASA, acetylsalicylic acid. Because here again, if the issue is inflammation, if we put the finger off the arm, you know, the pressure stopped. Well, we cause the inflammation to suppress a little bit. The pressing on the nerve hopefully will stop, and the pain will maybe not go away, but at least be controlled. Now, with your aspirin use, remember, we have to watch our folks for long-term aspirin use for GI issues. It can make stomach ulcers, you know, so be careful of that. Also, for long-term aspirin use, watch your residents, check with them once in a while about tinnitus, which is the ringing in the ears. If you're seeing either one of those things, you know, the upset stomach, and especially the BM turning black and tarry, or the ringing in the ears, you need to let the team leader know that you're basically seeing this. Now, some of the other drugs, some of the other classifications for arthritis are our non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, our NSAIDs. Popular ones today, of course, are Motrin, Naprosyn, Celebrex, which a lot of people call the miracle drug, and then, of course, Indocin, okay? Now, like any med, every drug has issues, has side effects. Now, here's a couple things you need to watch for some of these meds. Motrin, watch your cardiac resonance. Motrin, in a heart patient, will lower the cardiac output or the strength of the contraction of the heart. And with that happening, they could, what they're going to show first to you is an edema buildup, a fluid retention. You're going to look at the top of their foot and it's going to be puffy. They're starting to retain fluid because the Motrin has affected the heart. Yes, it may have helped the pain, but the side effect is it's affected the heart, lower the strength of the heart, and because it's not being as strong, it very possibly could cause this fluid backup. Naprosyn is kind of rough on the stomach, so watch it there. Celebrex, like I said, Celebrex for the most part, a lot of people with arthritis are basically going to call that the miracle drug because it just helps them so much. But it does have a side effect and needs to be watched for of tachycardia. It can actually make the person's heart race. And here again, we've said a couple different times through these series of teachings that our frail elderly cannot tolerate for very long a heart rate of 120, 130, 140. In all likelihood, it very well could precipitate a cardiac event. Indocin is another one that's used, you know, for the NSAID for pain for arthritis, but it again is pretty rough on the stomach. Most of your arthritic medicines are going to be rough on the stomach, on the GI tract, and any of those can cause stomach ulcers. And with any of our folks taking a lot of these arthritic medicines, meds for arthritis, we have to watch this GI problem with them. And there's another thing also that we need to kind of think outside the box here a little bit for our elderly that do have arthritis, that are taking arthritic medications like this, because Motrin, Naprosyn, you know, they not only have an anti-inflammatory effect, they have an antipyretic effect. Same with aspirin. It will lower the core body temperature of someone, okay? When my wife and I were first married, we didn't have air conditioning. She was a senior in nursing school, and I would, you know, in the hot summers, I'd be sweating in bed, and she'd say, take a couple Tylenol before you go to bed. You know, we couldn't afford air conditioning. And it worked. It lowered my body core temperature. I was cooler. I slept a lot better. So, arthritic medicines can do the same thing. They have, so many of them, an antipyretic effect. And while we're giving them for arthritis pain, they will lower the person's core body temperature. Now, I know we're taught, you know, 97.6 to 99.6 is our normal range for temperature, okay? Well, and this is what I mean by thinking outside the box a little bit. We have a person that we're giving arthritic medicines to, BID or TID. Those medicines could lower their core body temperature to say down to 96.5 or even a little bit lower. Then, on top of the meds for arthritis, they have a couple aches and pains during the day. So once in a while they ask you for a couple Tylenol, you know, during the day, you know, for pain. But the Tylenol again lowers their body temperature a little bit more. So what I'm getting at is thinking outside the box here. We could have some of our elderly where their normal core body, resting body temperature is more like 95.5 or 96 even, possibly 96.5, where it can be that low. And now, my temperature, become a diabetic, all your diabetics, or most of them I should say, shouldn't say all, most of them are going to tend to run on the higher level because of a faster metabolism. So I basically run 99.2, 99, you know, most of the time, okay? Now, if I have a 3-degree elevation or a 4-degree elevation from 99, I'm going to be pretty sick because my temperature from 99 is going to be 102, 103. And at 102, 103, I'm sick. I don't feel good. I ache. I have pain. You know, I'm just not doing that well. Well, and this is what I keep saying about think outside the box a little bit here. With our elderly that are having a core body temp of 96 or even lower than that, if they have a 3-degree elevation, they're just going to be 99. And if we're thinking in that box of 97.6 to 99.6, we're going to think they're all right. Because like they're not going to have the same manifestations. You know, the reaction to illness in the elderly slows down to the point where a lot of times they can have a pathogen, they can have an infection in them for even days before they start to manifest the signs and symptoms of being sick. The coughing, the vomiting, the diarrhea, whatever. So, but here again, like I said, when you do have somebody taking these arthritic meds, and they are taking some PRN, Tylenol, or whatever during the day, you know, they are going to have a lower body temperature on you. And when you take it and they're 99, you may need to do further investigation because they could be sick. Xyloprim is one of our big ones that is used today for basically gout. Muscle relaxants, what you see used a lot today, is either Soma or Robaxin. Now, and of course they just do their job. They relax the muscles if somebody has a lot of cramping going on and things like that. Flexeril is another muscle relaxant. Now, one of the things that we're seeing a little bit more and more and more of, you know, you remember your term from CMA class, synergism. It's where two meds are given at the same time together, and the giving of that increases the strength of them instead of each med separately, okay? And this is what we're kind of seeing sometimes with pain medicine. A doctor wants to give an elder person 50 milligrams, say, of Demerol. And, but the 50 milligrams of Demerol is a too much a narcotic for them. It's gonna cause maybe too much hallucinations, it's gonna cause too much restlessness, the reaction of it, too much nausea, too much constipation. But they need that much Demerol. Okay, what they may do is use this synergism effect of giving another pill along with the primary pill to make the primary pill stronger. And what they may do is use a muscle relaxant. Bring the Demerol down to 10 milligrams, but at the same time have you give a muscle relaxant with the 10 milligrams of Demerol. And what they're hoping for, and usually what happens is this synergism, and it's technically where you get your cake and get to eat it too. The benefit of the Demerol is like they got or received 50 milligrams, but they don't get all the side effects of 50 milligrams of Demerol. The hallucinations, the tremors, the spasticity, the nausea, the constipation, things like that. So you will sometimes see a muscle relaxant like Flexeril or something like that used in conjunction with a lower dose of a narcotic. Some of our bone growth regulators today, of course, are Fosamax and Boniva. And then there's another med, it's basically an anti-neoplastic drug, but it's also used a lot in RA, the crippling rheumatoid arthritis. It's called methotrexate. It's 2.5 milligram tablets. And most of your docs are gonna have you give 5 of that for a total of 7.5 milligrams. And it's usually once a week, you know? And because a lot of times your residents get so much wonderful relief from the pain of this crippling arthritis, they're watching the time clock here, you know, for, you know, they know it Monday at 10 a.m. they get their methotrexate and they want to make sure that they basically get it. So, looking at, again, some of your meds here in review, your anti-inflammatory drug, your aspirin, can be given oral suppository for mild to moderate pain. It reduces pain by reducing inflammation. Pulling the finger off the hand scenario, off the arm scenario. But it does have these other antipyretic effects, and remember, aspirin also does thin the blood. So even though you may be giving it for arthritis, you've got to watch out for these other things. Your non-steroidal anti-inflammatories like Motrin, Naprosyn, like I said,